Follow car number 6 in the outside column.
Okay, here we are, Texas Motor Speedway. Silver Crown for the Kneebon5 Championship. Sixty-seven laps here. I am the number 14 car out of...
We need to catch car number 6.
17, qualified 12th. Using Wayne's setup from the forums. Adjusted the stagger a little bit to tighten it up. Gonna throw some weight jacker in it. Hopefully take our time and not ruin anybody else's race. Really slow in practice. I'm shocked I got 12.
I'm gonna apologize in advance if I wreck anyone. I'm gonna do my best to hang on to this thing.
Yeah, so far the Randy's things, and these things are fun.
Oh yeah, they're a blast to drive. I love them.
Okay, Chad.
Still there. Clear low. Hold your line. Clear inside.
Was that?
No pressure, Chad. I'm just getting a feel for this thing right now.
That lap was a...
Hold your line, clear low.
All right, Chad, the next car is...
I didn't think you were going to check up that much.
You're good. Good surprise.
Keep it steady.
B13.
Clear low. Still there.
B12. Sounds clear to the bottom. B13.
Still there.
Okay, Chad, the next car.
Still there. Hold your line. Keep it steady. He's still there. Still there. Hold your line. Still there. Hold your line. Still there. Clear low. Hold your line. Clear to the bottom. Clear inside.
lap was that? The gap two. Last lap was it? Was that? Okay, Chad, the next car is. About that, was it? The gap two.
I guess now is the really boring part where you can hardly see anyone. You just don't have the line around here. Definitely not the setup, definitely the driver. 17th for the car in the pit. Not quite sure. how these guys find the speed around the track. I don't feel like my Lion's Orb, but I just can't keep up. Thing we can hope for now is a caution and cool the tires down and get another run at it.
We're halfway home. We're okay on fuel. That was 31.1.
From the looks of it, I don't think that's going to happen. It's a pretty clean race. Honestly, pretty clean series every race. Fairly clean, I feel like.
The gap to Cuba ahead is now 4.0 seconds.
Driving this car, it is a lot of fun. I guess it's Texas for me in this car.
The answer, Cuba ahead is now 4.7.
Can't figure it out. Dumb way to get some X points. If the car wasn't...
You've just done a 31.2.
Not driving to my liking before that. I doubt if we can drive any better now. Leader's showing up now, 15 seconds back for me.
Don't worry, boy, I'm not one of these guys that pushes it, so if I'm not there, I don't try to pass.
Right, the guy ahead of us is Forza.
What?
You cut me off. I was underneath you in the middle of 3 and 4 last time.
That lap time was 31.2.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that. I didn't mean it.
Forza ahead is increasing. It's now 7.0.
Clear this time.
Thank you.
gap to 4, sir. In front is now 8.6. Also, ahead is increasing. It's now 9.9.
15th place is full 10.5 seconds away.
That lap was a 31.2.
Leaders closing in. 10.5 seconds away now.
Time was 31.2.
Really hoping I was going to be able to save my car and then pass some guys later in the race, but apparently I wasn't saving the car at all. And never got that opportunity. Good news is I haven't destroyed anyone's race yet. Hoping I don't affect the leader when they come around and get me. I'm sure they will. And I might just be so bad that I'm
going to start. Also, ahead is now 11 seconds.
Running and a lap down. Not at all what I wanted or expected today, but I knew I was in trouble in practice. Just couldn't turn fast laps. Even with my qualifying run, I felt like I was slower than guys on their race practice laps. But
lap time was 31.4.
But I'll get points for 16.
The track temperature is increasing. It's now 45 Celsius.
For the Kneebon5 Championship. And they get fun. Looking forward to hearing about his.
Go ahead, Luke. You got me.
Coming up on his video.
See if we can chase those guys down.
Mentioned in practice. Mentioned in practice that he was going
to
release
the
details of his week 13 championship in this week's video. So sounds like it's going to be 43 car field, and everybody has to race their way in.
The gap to Orsef ahead is increasing. It's now 12 seconds. That lap was a 31.4.
And I think he said it was going to be at Michigan. I'm not sure how I'll do, so... have to see how it goes. Wes, who said he just started running these cars and helped with the setup.
Daniel, I'm gonna give it to you here in a second.
So I
okay, thank
you. Share Wayne's setup from the forum with him.
Pretty sure you're faster than I am.
And
you get back up on me, and I'm gonna let you by.
He's all the way up to third place. So, good race for Wes.
Yeah, let me catch back up. Yeah, I was trying to hopefully try to run down the front too, but I don't think we're fast enough.
The gap to Orsef ahead is increasing. It's now 13 seconds.
My lap is just getting trashier and trashier. 4 seconds now from the leader. Lapping me. Race needs to end.
You've just done a 31.4.
It'll be pretty critical that I stay out of Matt's way. That he catches me at the right time, less than a second ahead of second place.
Alright, go ahead. Thank you.
The gap to Orsef in front is now 14 seconds.
Like when he gave up third. Like Rich is gaining on that. I need to pay attention where I'm going.
I think you probably had a shot to catch up with him.
Car is crazy loose. I tightened it up at the beginning.
That last lap was a 31.3.
That's some stagger adjustment. And I thought I tightened it up too much, but I don't think I'd have been able to drive this thing right now if I wouldn't have done it. I guess I'm glad I did. Less than 2 seconds now. They're neck and neck for the lead. Gonna be a good battle. I don't want to have any influence on it at all. Well, I should have just drove down pit road.
Your last lap time was at 31.2.
I think I'm just gonna go. Matt and Rich, I'm gonna go slow down the bottom of the vector.
Higher than that, through 3 and 4.
Oh,
that looked bad. Can you confirm that you're all right? Please, Chad. We've got a full course yellow.
Sorry about that, guys.
Wrecking 3.
Pace car is out. Line up single file behind car number 7. Safety car's out. Pits are closed.
Well,
my goodness, these things are fun.
Tried to get out of the way and cause the caution. That was stupid. Apologize to the field.
And my hand needed that break. We're spinning for tires with a thing.
They got rid of that a season or two ago, I do believe.
Oh, yeah, I know. There's no tire changes, but yeah, I could use it.
Why did they do that?
I'm not totally sure. I think it had something to do with kind of, A, make it more realistic, and I think it was a vote on the forum also to make it single-file restarts and no tires.
The tires seem to last pretty well anyway. You can abuse the hell out of them, but, I mean, there's been a couple races where I could definitely use four new ones.
Has anybody put any more fuel in than what the stock setup had?
I think I'm just going to watch the end of this. I should have just came down pit road. Not wrecked it.
I just, I'll walk this way, so I'm doing my best to pull my tires up.
Moment of stupidity, got on the gas too hard. Really do apologize to the field, especially the guys up front. They were, you know, top two had this race between the two of them. And I cost them that chance to battle it out there.
I don't know if it's my imagination or not, but I swear I can see the wear line on your tire, though.
It's probably because I've been running like a negative 10 weight jacker since lap 30.
And that's why I'm at a negative 10.
That might be part of my problem. They're all running negative 10 on the weight
jacker. I started out just like, oh, let's try minus 2. And then I was like, oh, screw this all the way.
That could be why I was so slow.
I'm on negative 6 currently.
Is negative 10 the furthest you go?
Yes.
10-4.
Hey, Lee, did I screw you up 20 laps ago, or did you just get real loose and have to drop back?
No. This week...
You're talking to me?
Because it was harder.
I was talking to Lee, number 6 car.
Tell you, thank you.
Oh, my bad. I thought you said lead.
Is anyone changing weight jackers between the corners, or is that just me?
I'm not that coordinated.
Just you. I don't touch anything unless I'm on straight away.
No, but I've done that before. Like, you're talking about changing before you get to the corner, each individual.
Yeah, I've
done that before, not in this race, but...
Oh shit, this is a green light checker? Damn, Jim, stop copying me. Totally joking, by the way.
I have no idea if it works or not.
I don't know, this room ain't as toxic as like a lot of rooms I've been in. I like that.
Yeah, I think that's Silver Crown thing. I've pretty respectable racing here.
The season has been awesome and fun to drive with, even if I've had a bad race.
Yep, same.
right, let's see here. The 3 car would be Matt. 10 car is Rich. Matt gets to a good jump there on this green-white checker. Rich now is in battle second place, which he shouldn't have been, except I gave him caution. It's like Matt's the class of the field. Rich did a good job holding off the battle for second. Rich now gained a little. Matt looks like he's pulling back ahead. Wes, good showing in fourth.
Good racing. Good, Brian. Nice move.
Good racing. Fun as always. Love this place.
And Matt's going to win it.
Good racing, everyone.
Well, thanks for watching. Sorry it wasn't more entertaining.
Good race, guys.